This is The Association. They are a sunshine pop band from California. Where in California, you ask? During the 60s, with a bunch of hits, they are known for their intricate vocal harmonies. Founder Jules Alexander, born in 1943 in Chattanooga, Tennessee, was in the Navy, stationed in Hawaii in 62. When he met Terry Kirkman, who was born in 1939 in Salina, Kansas, Kirkman grew up in Chino, California. These two friends jammed and promised to get together when Alexander finished his stint in about a year. Talk about planning ahead. Kirkman had been playing with Frank Zappa before he formed the Mothers. At a Monday night hootenanny in an LA nightclub, a pickup group was formed called the Inner Tubes with Kirkman, Alexander, and Doug Dillard. This rotating lineup also saw Cass Elliott and David Crosby at one time. This gave rise to a group called The Men, a 13-piece rock band. The Men were separated from the boys, and there were six left, and this remnant became The Association. This lineup had Alexander on vocals and lead guitar, Kirkman on vocals and brass, Brian Cole from Tacoma, Washington on vocals and bass and woodwinds, Russ Giglieri from Portsmouth, New Hampshire on vocals, percussion, and guitar, and Ted Blushel Jr. from San Pedro, California on drums, guitar, bass, and vocals, and later Jim Yester on vocals, guitar, and keyboards. The Association signed with Jubilee and issued a single, Babe, I'm Gonna Leave You.
Singing groups in the nation, and they appeared on our show last season, and we found
that's Tommy Smothers.
It was just terrific. The public didn't care for them too much, but
you tell it, Tom.
We decided to have them back anyway, and here they are singing Never My Love, The Association.
I love this song. Their single, Babe, I'm Gonna Leave You, originally recorded by Joan Baez and later by Led Zeppelin. Along Comes Mary was their breakthrough, but it was controversial in the 60s because Mary was a term that meant marijuana. So there were maybe five people that thought they meant Along Came Marijuana. The song went to number 7 in the U.S., also from their first album, Cherish, which went to number 1. Kirkman wrote it. It was a dance ballad, slow dance. Jerry Yester produced their next installment. He would go on to be a member of the Lovin' Spoonful. There were no hit singles on Renaissance. In 66, Warner bought their label and their contract. Alexander left to study meditation in India. Larry Ramos from Waimea, Hawaii replaced him. I guess that's Waimea. My apologies, Hawaii. Ramos had been a new Christie minstrel. He sang co-lead on Windy and Never My Love, two of the Association's biggest hits. They were the first act to perform at the Monterey Pop Festival in 67, in June of 67. Never My Love became the second most played song on the radio in the 20th century. Imagine that. Who was first? You've Lost That Love and Feeling by the Righteous Brothers, and Yesterday by Paul McCartney was third. The Association's last two hits were Everything That Touches You and Time for Living. Alexander returned from India and rejoined, but this did not provide any enlightenment for the band. They were the 60s, not the 70s. Cole, 29, died from a heroin OD in 72. Kirkman left. Alexander left in 73. The nostalgia circuit beckoned, and some of the association came around for another go in 1981. The Turtles, Gary Puckett, and Spanky in Our Game. Spanky and Our Gang welcomed the association, and they all went everywhere and did everything again. And that is a moment to cherish.
Can new Rubik's Impossible really impossible? Or does
damn.
It just have you
don't you love the ads? They're just so fun when they come up and talk like assholes.